a man had a big hassle at the bistro late one night. He happened to pass the bar when a loud, sloshed Prussian poured some beer into his glass. Thank you, said Pocket Man, never one to say no to a refill. Sometime after midnight, though, this ultra-fine Prussian, who seemed as if he may have come into the bistro to recruit us into the regiment, noticed that his wallet containing $300, credit cards, and very important papers was missing. Since our ragged mullah looked like the person who could benefit most from the 300 smackers, he became the prime suspect. The stormtrooper marched over to the table where Pocket Man was now sitting with Judiakus and a few others and ordered him to go into the toilet with him to be searched. Pocket Man said no, that would be impossible. Not only was he insulted, but to empty his pockets anywhere is a laborious, time-consuming task. And Pocket Man empties them only for people he likes. His accuser assumed that because he had bought Pocket Man a beer, it followed that he must have taken his wallet. You didn't buy me a beer, you only poured some into my glass, Pocket Man corrected. Judy, the actress, found some of Pocket Man's associates standing at the bar and told us he was in trouble. Suddenly, the Gestapo was trying to drag Pocket Man into the toilet. The mullah broke away and ran to the bar shouting, "You dummy, I didn't take your wallet!" "What's the trouble?" asked the big Turkish emigre who spoke broken English. A number of other people stood up. "What's the trouble?" The waiters gathered round. "Qua, il ma derange." How's my French there, remember? Okay, go. Suddenly, the whole bistro stood up behind Pocket Man. To accuse the mullah of being dishonest, a thief, is the worst effrontery. "I'm just asking," said the stormtrooper. "I'm not accusing," but he pronounced it excusing. "I'm not excusing him, I'm just asking. I want to see what's in his pockets." "All right, you dummy," Pocket Man said, and began spreading the contents of his pockets on the sink counter. He was like a magician, pulling an endless stream of colored handkerchiefs out of his pockets. They seemed bottomless, a wonderland. Soon, half the counter was littered with the pocket's miracles. "I don't have your wallet, you dummy. I am just asking, I'm not excusing. Are you looking for trouble?" The waitress and friends and Pocket Man moved in. We were ready to wipe the stormtrooper out. "I'm not excusing. I think I'm just ruined." It took the mullah at least half an hour to gather together his pockets. They were so organized before, now everything's mixed up. "Where's my handkerchief?"
At the end of the bar.
So, at the end of our lives, I think, before we draw our last breath, we all have to ask ourselves, yes?
All the background noise.
So, background noise?
It's really hard to hear.
Okay, a little louder? Okay. Before we get to the end of our lives, we all have to ask ourselves an important question. Were we led by this or by this? Bon voyage on your next adventure, Roy, and glad I'm your friend. Woo! Dan Evans.